Hello everyone, and welcome to my Days of Lies official channel. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day. Before we begin, please hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. EJ congratulated Eric and Sloane on the news of Sloane's pregnancy at Salem University Hospital. After numerous awkward silences, EJ attempted to lighten the situation with small chat and dumb jokes. Eric and Sloane walked away. Nicole commended EJ sarcastically on how he handled the situation. EJ said at the Dimmero Mansion that he had merely wanted to be polite to Eric and Sloane. Nicole chastised EJ for his effort at levity. Nicole was furious, according to EJ, because Sloane was going to have Eric's baby. Nicole stated that she was unhappy simply because EJ believed she still had feelings for Eric. Nicole informed EJ that she loved him and was overjoyed to be having a kid with him. Nicole stated that Sloane was the most bothersome, and that something about Sloane's pregnancy didn't add up. Nicole referred to Sloane as a tarantula, and she stated that having a child would forever bind Sloane to Eric, which is why she got pregnant, Nicole pointed out. Nicole told EJ that she enjoyed their life together and that she needed to concentrate on them and their child. EJ and Nicole kissed as they imagined their future together. Sloane dressed for a pregnancy exam at a hospital exam room. Sloane became concerned when Eric mentioned that EJ and Nicole had discussed genetic testing for their child. Given Nicole's medical background, Eric stated that Nicole and EJ were solely concerned about potential health risks for the baby. After Eric had gone to find out what was taking the doctor so long, Sloane was concerned that Nicole's pregnancy with Eric's child would be revealed. Sloane stated she was mainly concerned about Nicole when Eric returned. After everything she's been through, seeing this baby through to term, I just don't want them to have any bad news, Sloane explained. Gwen wanted to have sex with Dimitri in Leo and Gwen's Salem in room the night before their wedding. Dimitri claimed he had obligations. Gwen was irritated. Dimitri requested that Gwen refrain from fighting the night before their wedding. Dimitri walked away. Alex appeared shirtless at the door of Chad and Stephanie's apartment. Stephanie chastised Alex for being shirtless after she and Chad had clearly instructed him to do so. Chad slammed the door in Alex's face after some brief chat. Chad was enraged and lashed out at Alex. Stephanie reminded Chad that the couple had scheduled an evening alone. They were interrupted once more as Dimitri knocked on the door. Dimitri invited Chad and Stephanie to Gwen's wedding. Chad laughed at Dimitri and Gwen's perfect match, given their checkered pasts. Where are you going on your honeymoon, you two kids? Hell, I'm hoping, Chad said. Dimitri attempted to persuade Chad that the two guys were related. Dimitri mentioned Stephanie and Gwen as family. Stephanie declared that she would never forget what Gwen had done to Abigail. Chad slammed the door in Dimitri's face. Chad later puzzled why Dimitri would want him and Stephanie to attend the wedding. Chad suspected that something was wrong with the wedding. Trask informed Lai that she was his date for the evening at Small Bar. Lai was interrupted by a woman named Connie, who introduced herself as his date. Lai sat at the same table as Connie. Trask was curious about her date. Trask had just noticed Alex. Alex went on and on about his life. Alex was clearly boring Trask. Trask informed Alex that the two of them had no future together. Trask complained that Alex talked too much and had an unpleasant habit of taking his spectacles on and off. Trask went on to say that it was evident that Alex was still in love with Stephanie. Lai stood nearby, uninterested, while Connie rambled on about her life. Connie stated that Lai attempted to assassinate Stefan. Lai denied any involvement, and he was surprised when Connie revealed she felt aroused after listening to a podcast about Lai's plan to kill Stefan. Trask and Lee afterwards revealed that their dates had both been awful. Trask had ordered the same bottle of Chardonnay that the two of them had enjoyed on their previous date, according to Lai. Trask invited Lai to accompany her, and Lai accepted. Chad and Stephanie were getting ready to depart for dinner when they ran into Alex again in the hallway. Alex revealed that his date had not gone as planned. For a brief period, Chad appeared to feel sad for Alex. Chad invited Alex to accompany him and Stephanie to the Brady pub. Alex quickly agreed. Gwen returned to Leo and Gwen's room and informed him that Dimitri had refused to have sex with her. Leo remembered being in bed with Dimitri. An uneasy Leo intimated that Gwen may still call off the wedding if she believed Dimitri was uninterested in her. Leo worked fast to retract his remark. Gwen expressed gratitude for having Leo as a best friend. Gwen encircled Leo, whose expression remained troubled. Dimitri returned to Gwen's room a short time later. Gwen apologized for arguing with Dimitri and explained that she needed to conduct an errand for the spectator. Dimitri and Leo kissed after Gwen left. Leo broke off the kiss, explaining that he was conflicted about his love for Dimitri because Gwen was his best friend. Dimitri leaned in to kiss Leo again, saying that what Gwen didn't know couldn't damage her. Gwen had left her phone in the room and was on her way back, unbeknownst to Leo and Dimitri. Thanks for watching if you like this video, so please don't forget to subscribe my channel and don't miss any update.